Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1987, Workbook Default Settings. Hey, I'll be podcasting this whole book. Click that I in the top right-hand corner to get to the playlist for all of the items. This is one of my favorite tips of all time. Every time that I create a brand new workbook, I have to go through and do several different customizations. Here, I'm just going to do CTRL+N. Here's what I do all the time. I go to page layout. I say page setup, header footer, custom footer, whatever your company is, right? I used to work for this guy, Highly Confidential, for senior executive eyes only. Yours probably just says confidential or something like that. Margins, I've been using these margins forever, 0.25, 0.25, 0.25. The footer I put at 0.25 and the bottom at 0.5, center on page horizontally. Page fit to one page wide by blank pages tall, right? Now, yeah, I know there's narrow margins here, but hey, those aren't narrow, 0.75, 0.75. I want my narrow margins, and I just want them to be there by default. Some other things you can do, and some of these may seem really crazy. Let's build a quick pivot table here. Use that custom list that we have. All right, so insert, pivot table. I'm just going to put it off to the right-hand side. Click OK. Product, sales. See that color? I like that color. That's the color I want. I've right-clicked and said, set this as the default. But that's useless because it doesn't stick. It's gone when you create a new workbook. Well, I actually, in my original workbook, created a pivot table, made it be the default, and then deleted the pivot table, right? So now there's no pivot table left. How about on cell styles? Do any of these annoy you? Yeah, a lot of them annoy me. Why are the input cells supposed to be orange? Ah, well, hey, they don't have to be orange. You can right-click any of these, modify, go into format, and change to whatever you want. Click OK, click OK. All right, see, so now in this workbook, the calculation is this horrible orange on green, but at least I got to pick the horrible orange on green instead of having someone from the Excel team force it upon me. Maybe you go in and you have a named range. You always create a named range of tax rate is 6.5%. Well, define the name. So you're creating a single worksheet book, putting all of your favorite settings in, and then you're going to save that workbook into a special place with a special name and a special type. Here's the thing you have to ask yourself. Do you use macros? If so, then you're going to save it as XLTM. Or are you never going to use macros? Then you're going to save it as XLTX. We're going to save that workbook into this folder, App Data, Microsoft Excel, Excel Start, with two names, Book and Sheet. Book is what you get when you do CTRL+N for new, and Sheet is what you get when you do Insert Worksheet. All right, so I'll come back here. Here's our workbook. It has all my favorite settings. File, Save As, Browse. We're going to change this from XLSM to, for me, XLTM. If you're never going to use macros, then maybe you use XLTX. And watch out, when you do that, they go deep down here into this crazy folder. I'm going to change that. I'm going to say percent app data. Percent, like that. And that goes to your app data. From there, Microsoft, Excel, and then Excel Start. And this is where you're going to save it as book, and then do a second save as, exact same file, as sheet. All right, now I'm going to cancel because I've already done that. And then here's what we get. Anytime that you're in Excel and you press CTRL+N for new, you will have all of your favorite settings. Page layout, my margins are right, my header footer is right, the cell styles are right. If I create a pivot table, it's going to be in the correct color. The reason you need to save it as sheet is if you insert a sheet using either the new sheet or insert worksheet, it won't inherit the settings from book XLTM, but it will inherit the settings from sheet XLTM. All right, now, I have a bit of a rant here about Microsoft and the way that things work. Okay, I just closed and reopened Excel, and they bring me to this, the start screen. And here on the start screen, they're offering this first tile called a blank workbook. This blank workbook, if you would go back to Excel 2003, was a feature called new dot dot dot. It was hidden. No one would ever find it. You had to go to the File menu to find new dot dot dot. Everyone just used the icon on the standard toolbar called new. No dot dot dot. Well, somehow, when we jump from 2003 to 2007, the great new icon without the dots got lost, and new dot 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 became the one that we see. And now, thanks to the start screen, it's right here in your face. This has its own settings, not your settings, not the book XLTM settings. This is evil. We don't want this. So when I get to this screen, I never click this one because it's going to have someone else's settings. I want my settings, so I press Escape. Escape brings me to a workbook with all of my favorite settings. Or I just press Control-N. Or if it annoys you as much as it annoys me, we can go to File, Options, and right here just say, don't show me the start screen anymore. That way you'll always get your book XLTM. I've discussed this with the Excel team. They conceptually understand why it's bad, but there's something that I don't understand that they can't seem to change it. So here we are. Now, all month I've been talking about how this book will save you some time. This feature, setting up book XLTM, you know, it takes you 5 minutes to do it right the first time, and then every time you create a workbook, you're going to save a minute at least. Think about over the course of your lifetime, all the hours and dozens and hundreds of hours you're going to save not having to change the margins from now on. Click that I in the top right hand corner to go out and buy the book right now. I would really appreciate it. All right, recap of this issue. We're going to save all your favorite settings in a new workbook. You have to start with a blank workbook with one sheet. Do all the favorite customizations, anything you like, the ones I suggested or yours. Decide, are we doing XLTM to allow macros or XLTX without macros? Do a save as, change the extension, then go to %appdata%. That'll get you to the right folder where you can choose then Microsoft, then Excel, then Excel Start. Save it twice, once as book, once as sheet. From then on, Control-N or Insert Worksheet to inherit the settings from book or sheet. The book was crowdsourced. Everyone sent in their favorite tip. It was Joanne Babin who sent in an idea similar to this one. So thanks to Joanne for this tip. Thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.